It's a great honor for me to be here amongst such esteemed colleagues from all Europe, and so I would like to thank very much the organizer of this very interesting conference. First of all, I shall spend a minute illustrating the reasons that led me to dedicate my presentation to a topic which could seem quite specific about the general debate on codification, that is, the topics of compensation for non-pecuniary damage. I found this theme particularly significant of a special technique by which civil codification, now in force for over 81 years, like the Italian one, such as the Italian one, can evolve and transform and therefore be reformed. It is a technique that has seen judges' decision, in particular those of the Italian Constitutional Court and of the Italian Supreme Court, play a key role in a framework in which, instead, the text of the civil code as such has remained unchanged. The judges' decision, in turn, were largely prepared from the writings of scholars. So, in the field, a particularly fruitful form of interaction between doctrine and jurisprudence has emerged. And this interaction can be just considered as a model for the development of a civil code also in other areas. The relevance of the topics, which the brief presentation will lead us to address, also results from the very recent decision of the Court of Justice of the European Union of 4 May 2023 in case C-321, which, facing a problem of compensation for non-pecuniary damage from unlawful processing of personal data, affirms some principles of general importance on the subject. I said just now that with regard to compensation for non-pecuniary damage, the legislative data within the Italian Civil Code has never been amended. It is therefore still in force in its original text, Article 2059, according to which non-pecuniary damage must be compensated only in cases determined by law. The reasons which led the Italian legislator to introduce this provision are still under discussion. The most reliable reading of them sees at the base a consideration of policy that had induced the legislature of the time, influenced by the ideology of the fascist regime, to reject the bourgeois conception of civil liability, of which the French Civil Code was instead an expression. In fact, the idea that even non-patrimonial values could always be converted into pecuniary benefits was typical of the bourgeois conception just mentioned, at least according to the reading that the legislator of Italian Code of 1942 gave of it. Instead, the Italian legislator of 1942, limiting the compensation of non-pecuniary damage only to cases determined by law, had wanted to affirm the idea according to which non-pecuniary damage had to be compensated only when the unlawful act determined a particularly serious offense of the values founding the legal system. For that very reason, the cases determined by the law of compensation for non-pecuniary damage, to which Article 2059 refers, largely coincided with those in which the unlawful act also constituted a crime. In fact, an article of criminal Italian code, that is Article 185, provided and still provides that the offender is required to pay compensation for the damage, including non-pecuniary damage, that the crime has caused. However, this structure of the discipline of compensation for non-pecuniary damage in the Civil Code has been called quickly into question by the entry into force of the 1948 Constitution in Italy. The latter, as well as other constitutional texts that came into force after the end of World War II, let's think, for example, of the German Grundgesetz of 1949, has placed at the center of the hierarchy of values which it has affirmed the need to protect the human person, his dignity, and his fundamental rights. The next step has been easy, although not quick. Given that non-pecuniary damage derives mainly from the injury of non-pecuniary interest, and therefore from the violation of the rights of the person, The need to protect the letter in a full and effective manner has led to doubt the conformity with the Constitution of a discipline that limited the compensation for non-pecuniary damage to only cases in which the fact also constituted a crime. This doubt arose, first of all, with regard to the non-material damage resulting from the violation of the right to health. This right is, in fact, protected in a very incisive way by Article 32 of the Italian Constitution. We read in this provision that the Republic protects health as a fundamental right of the individual. Therefore, the constitutional protection of this right has led to the affirmation of a sort of Drittwirkung of the right to health, creating the conditions for a broad compensatory protection of non-pecuniary damage to health. The argument proposed by a judgment of the Italian Constitutional Court dating back in time, number 184 of 1986, to achieve this result, can be summarized as follows. Article 2059 does not refer to the entire area of non-pecuniary damage, but only to damage consisting of pain or suffering. The damage to health, in and in itself considered instead, finds its discipline directly in the general rule of the Civil Code on civil liability, namely in the Article 2043. The latter identifies the condition of compensation for damage in its injustice, which in turn certainly exists where the damage results from the violation of a right protected by the Constitution. Therefore, this was the conclusion which allowed the Constitutional Court to exclude the constitutional illegitimacy of Article 2059, the non-pecuniary damage to health with its own peculiar nature, such as to distinguish it both from patrimonial damage, both from subjective moral damage, can be compensated on the basis of a direct application of Article 32 of the Constitution, read in relation to Article 2043 of the Civil Code. The judgment number 184-86 of the Constitutional Court paved the way for the elaboration of the category of biological damage, meant precisely as damage to health in and of itself considered, category that has been defined as an Italian way to the compensation for personal damage. In my speech today, for reason of time, I cannot dwell on other moments in the evolution of the category of biological damage. I would simply like to recall that a few years after the aforementioned sentence, another judgment of the Constitutional Court, number 372/1994, led the damage to health back to the provision of Article 2059, stating that an interpretation of this provision in the light of Article 32 of the Constitution required in any case the compensation for that damage, because the cases determined by the law had to be meant precisely taking into account the bond deriving from the Constitution. The argumentative model that led to affirm the compensation for damage to health on the basis of the direct application of constitutional rules was quickly extended to other interests or profiles of the person and to the damages resulting from their violation. In fact, on the one hand, the Italian Constitution contains a provision, Article 2, which recognizes and guarantees in very broad terms the inviolable human rights. On the other hand, the European Convention on Human Rights and more recently the Charter of Fundamental Rights of the European Union have also come into play. These normative texts have drawn a very wide sphere of protection of the human person and his interests, and have therefore created the premises for a very significant compensatory protection. This approach had the merit of widening the scope of compensatory protection of the person in the presence of non-pecuniary damage, protection that the category of biological damage limited to the area of damage to health. At the same time, and on the contrary, it has created the risk of an excessive expansion of the area of non-pecuniary damages, because, in fact, if every interest of the person as constitutionally protected, if harmed, can found an unjust damage and therefore compensable in relation to the provision of Article 2043 of the Civil Code, the conditions are created for a generalized compensation for non-pecuniary damage, Also, a standard to what in Italy has taken the name of existential damage, and which is similar to the category known in English law as loss of amenities of life. It then becomes necessary to introduce a filter to the compensation of these damage profiles in order not to empty the rule contained in Article 2059 above mentioned, and also to avoid the proliferation of trivial compensation claims. This is the context of the subsequent jurisprudential intervention of the Supreme Court, represented by the judgments of the United Session of the Court of Cassation, Supreme Court, in November 2008. These judgments have argued, first of all, the unitary nature of the category of non-material damage, which cannot be articulated internally through the recognition of an independent relevance to existential damage. Moreover, in order to arrive at a synthesis between the need for wide recognition of the protection of compensation for the interest of the person and the opposing need to avoid an excessive expansion of judicial claims relating to minor non-material prejudices, the judgments affirmed that the assumption for the reparability of non-material damage is that it has led to the infringement of constitutionally guaranteed inviolable rights. And they then specified that the seriousness of the offense constitutes a further requirement for admission to a compensation for non-pecuniary damages to the person resulting from the violation of inviolable constitutional rights. Therefore, at least in the field of non-pecuniary damage, the Italian regulatory system came up at a solution very similar to that one contained in the draft common frame of reference, where it is present, also referring to the area of pecuniary damage, the so-called de minimis rule, according to which trivial damage is to be disregarded. It should be pointed out, however, that the very recent decision of the Court of Justice of the European Union, aforementioned on damage caused by violation of privacy, stated that Article 82 of the General Protection Data Regulation must be interpreted as precluding a national rule or practice which makes compensation for non-material damage subject to the condition that the damage suffered by the person concerned has reached a certain degree of seriousness, both because Article 82 refers to the concept of non-material damage without mentioning a threshold of seriousness, and in the light of general protection data regulation need to ensure a consistent and high level of protection of individuals with regard to the processing of personal data throughout the European Union. The subsequent developments of the problem on compensation for non-material damage in the jurisprudence of the Italian Supreme Court can be briefly described in terms of a partial overcoming of the principles affirmed by the judgments of 2008, illustrated just now, and of an increasingly marked attention to issues relating to proof and liquidation of damages. In particular, the overcoming of the principles affirmed by the aforementioned case law can be seen in the articulation of the category of the non-pecuniary damage. The idea that is proposed by an orientation developed in 2018 is in fact in the sense that any injury caused to an interest protected by the constitutional charter is characterized by double dimension of damage, the dimension of the relational external protection of being and that of the moral damage intimistic internalization of suffering. The procedure which the court must carry out in order to verify the existence of non-pecuniary damage that can be compensated, therefore, presupposes, first of all, the identification of the right of the protected person at the constitutional level. Subsequently, the court must carry out the analysis on the level of proof, both of the inner aspect of the damage, moral suffering in all its aspects, such as pain, shame, remorse, self-esteem, melancholy, sadness, as well as of its worsening, modifying impact with the daily life that returns to evoke the idea of existential damage. In general, Italian jurisprudence is, however, constant in stating that the person who intends to obtain compensation for non-pecuniary damage must prove it, even by means of presumption, since damage, so-called ira ipsa, is not admissible. From this point of view, there is a significant similarity with the jurisprudence of the Court of Justice of the European Union just mentioned, namely the decision of 4 May 2023, which excluded that mere violation of the rules of general protection data regulation can lead to a non-pecuniary damage compensable. Then, once again, the prospect of liquidation and its criteria take decisive importance when one wonders about the function of compensation for non-pecuniary damage. In fact, the attribution of relevance in the perspective of the quantification of this item of damage to aspects also concerning the seriousness of the conduct of the person responsible or of the particular merit of protection of the injured interest offers food for thought of component that a compensation sentence in the field of damage is this destined to assume also from sanctioning point of view. From this point of view, it has been affirmed by some scholars that a measure of compensation for non-pecuniary damage is also related to the seriousness of the fact and the proportionality of the sanction that overall the legal system imposes also in preventive function on its author. Even in Italy, there are questions, but for now it is still and only a doctrinal debate on the possibility of introducing as a competing criterion for the liquidation of non-pecuniary damage from injury to personality rights that of the profit obtained by the offender who has committed it intentionally in order to achieve a profit contained in Article 633, paragraph 3 of the Belgian draft reform of civil liability law. In the background of the approach that attributes importance to the seriousness of the conduct of the person responsible for the purpose of liquidating non-pecuniary damage, there is once again a ruling of the Supreme Court, that is sentence 16601 of 2017, which affirmed the principle according to which in the current legal system, civil liability is not assigned only the task of restoring the patrimonial sphere of the subject who suffered the injury, since the deterrence function and the sanctioning function of the civil responsible are internal to the system. From this principle, the judgment has affirmed the corollary according to which it is not ontologically incompatible with the Italian legal system, the institution of American origin of punitive compensation. I hope that the brief and certainly superficial exposition carried out has nevertheless been able to offer a picture of a way in which compensation for non-pecuniary damage has been modified during the 81 years of validity of the Italian Civil Code by means of the intervention of jurisprudence in the wake of the contribution of doctrine and through the concretization of the general principles contained in the Constitution of 1948. Thank you very much.